Hello, hello, welcome everyone. Testing, testing, testing. Welcome to another live ukulele jam with me, Matt Stead. Sorry, there was a bit of a mix up with the times earlier. The original link I posted went to 3:30, but you guys managed to figure it out, which is great. Always lots of buffering at the start, so I'll just play a little ditty for you, just something for us all to warm up with, and then we'll get started properly after that. If you could just let me know if the sound is all right, guys, that'll be absolutely marvellous. There we go. Hope you're all keeping well. Let's see who's here. Here we go. Hi, guys. Hi, Shell. There we go. Oh, you found the new link. Brilliant. Fantastic. Rainy Mull up there. Yeah, it's all a bit dark and gloomy down here as well. Kind of felt like we had false spring last week, because last week it really felt kind of sunny and warm, and I saw my first butterfly, a red admiral. I'll see if I can bring a picture of it up later. So I was super excited, you know, it's like spring's on the way and everything, but of course it's gone cold and rainy again. But that's fine, we can cope with that, because we're going to have loads and loads of fun tonight. We've got some great songs tonight. Hi everyone. Buffering should settle down in a minute. Good news is, as I mentioned last week, I've got my super fast broadband. I've been promising it for months, but it's actually been booked in now to be delivered on the 4th of March. So we've got 3 more Kanikapilas, and then all the buffering should be a thing of the past. So I extra appreciate you guys for bearing with me whilst it's been a bit rubbish these last few weeks in terms of the speed and everything. But we're nearly there, so yeah. Hi, Steve. Good to see you. Hi, guys. Cool. Hi, Sue. Nice to see you. Nice to see you. So tonight, yes, we've got all sorts tonight. We've got a song from my favourite band, Belle and Sebastian, tonight. That's a bit of an esoteric one just to throw in there, because I always like to do that. We've got a song by the Beatles, an absolute cracker. We've also got a little bit of Carole King, a really, really beautiful, beautiful song by Carole King, one of my favourites, actually. I think there's one more that I've forgotten. Oh, we're going to do a Paul McCartney tune as well. So your people's choice was a tie this week, I think, between I'll Fly Away or Wildwood Flower, one of those old-time ones, and Mull of Kintyre. So I decided to go with Mac, because, you know, I'm a bit of a Beatles obsessive. Oh, thanks, Laura. Thank you. That was from the James Hill book, that was. I sometimes teach using James Hill's method, which is absolutely fantastic. So that's one of his arrangements, actually. I can't claim that one, but it's a lovely tune, isn't it? When Irish eyes are smiling. I thought it'd be nice, because it's got that lyric about sure 'tis like the spring, which I thought was lovely. Okay, let's bring our sheets on for tonight. I hope you're all doing well. Thanks, Peter. Thanks for letting me know, mate. So we we will have a look at the sheets. I'll do a little break in the middle and I'll explain about some of the things we've got coming up. Remembering that, for instance, this Wednesday is the next live lesson. I'm quite excited about this one because it's open to everyone. We're going to do time signatures. So it's for beginners and advanced alike. And I think you'll all get something out of it, which will be really, really exciting. So tonight we've got lots of songs. Funnily enough, we've got lots in the key of A tonight, which we haven't done. We quite often play in C, don't we? Next most common key is probably G and then F, but we've got some in A. And we've got some kind of classic, almost like 12-bar blues. And we're actually going to carry this on to next week, where we've got more blues in the key of A as well. So lots of pop as well, so don't worry. But this song is in the key of A. So we can count up on our hands in the key of A. So we've got A, B. The C is a C sharp in the key of A. You don't have to worry about that, but just know it goes A, B, C sharp, D, E, F, and a G sharp. All right, those are the notes that come up in the key of A. And we can think of those as chords. And as we all know, our one chord which makes you feel at home and settled is the one chord. And more often than not, our one chord starts the song and ta-da! This is no exception. We've got an A major to start us off, so we call that the one chord. Just like an F with your finger moved up. Nice, simple one, that one. Okay, I'll go over strum patterns in a minute, but we have this A. Now we have a really unusual chord in this one. Well, not totally unusual, just as in that it's not in the key. The seventh chord, which should be G sharp, we're going to play as just a normal G, which the good news is that's actually easier than G sharp. That's the flatted seventh chord. That comes up loads in indie music and rock and roll. And that's because in the blues and rock and roll and, you know, where indie originated, those flatted notes, the flatted seventh and the flatted third, are really, really important. So that's a really common thing to come up. And then mostly the whole of the rest of the song is just the four chord, which just creates a sense of change. So that's D, A, B, C, D. All right, so relatively straightforward, this one. So let's have a look at how it works, for instance, in a verse. We would have A, each one of these boxes is a measure or four beats. So we would have A for four beats. Jojo was a man who. A7 for four. 40 was a loner. That's really common before we go to the next chord because that A7 feels unresolved. A kind of just sits there happily. But notice how just that one note difference, that A7, feels like it's asking a question. And that A7 is five notes above D. So it wants to resolve there. So it's really common to have a chord as a seventh above the next one. And then we go back to A. Now there's a couple of ways you can strum this. The first is just a really straightforward up and down. So I'm just counting in verses. One and two and three and four. One and two and three and four. And one and two and three and four. And one and two and three and four. What I like to do is I like to make it a little bit more kind of Beatles-esque. And I like to do straight eights very, very quickly like this. So instead of one and two and three and four, I'll just do down strums like this. One and two and three and four and one and two and three and four and one and two and three and four. See that? Now, that means that we can do something super clever. If we want to thicken it up even further, we can just add some ups. Hear that? Your hand's already coming up to do another down. Just strike it on the way up. You could kind of count it as one and two and a three E and a four E and a. But try not to think about it too much. Just think of it as a rhythm. All right. That would sound something like this. See? And that gives you that kind of, that gives you that real kind of Beatles-esque groove, because this one was the one that they performed on the roof. You know, when they did the Let It Be album, which wasn't the last album they recorded, interestingly, because they recorded it with all the sessions up on the roof and everything, as well as in the studio. But they actually released it after Abbey Road, which they recorded after Let It Be. So chronologically, it goes Abbey Road, Let It Be. But in terms of when they're recorded, it's Let It Be, Abbey Road. It's just an interesting thing if you're into that. But this was the one that they did with the rooftop gig, and it's got that really kind of groove to it, which is really lovely, isn't it? Now, the intro has a really cool thing going on. It has a measure of A. Then it has another half a measure of A, one and two, and a G for one beat and a D for one beat. It'll sound like this. One, two, three, four, one, two, G, D. One, two, three, four, one, two, G, D. Cool, isn't it? That now it's like got a real groove to it, which is really loads of fun. And notice a similar thing happens in the chorus, almost the same, but we've got some sevenths. So the chorus, we do A to A7. That's really easy, because all you've got to do is lift this finger away. All right, remember, you haven't got to do my groovy strum if you find it difficult. Just do up and down strums, or even down strums. But that would sound like this. A, A7, A, A7, D, A, G. See that little fast G, D at the end? Let's give that a go, just that first line of the chorus after four. One, two, three, four. A7, A, A7, D, two A's. One, two, G, D. Let me go again. A, A7, A, A7. This time just D for a whole measure, and then A. Right, so you'll soon get that. You'll soon get that, and you'll enjoy it. Oh, Karen's doing it with a chuck. You're just showing off now, Karen. Just teasing. That's absolutely brilliant. Well done, Karen. Okay, so let's have a look at one more thing. And this is my bad. This isn't Karen's. Did some brilliant help with the sheets this week. Thank you, Karen. I realised that where it says intro and interludes, the interlude part, and you'll find out when to play them on the next sheet. If I just move this over, you'll see there your next sheet has all the words on, and you've got the organisation. So intro, verse one, chorus, then one of these interludes, chorus, verse two, chorus, interlude. So it's basically just verse and choruses, but with this little interlude mixed in. And originally I wrote the interlude as this up here, but when I was listening to the actual track earlier, just to triple check, I'm glad I did. Really, the interlude is actually the first line of the chorus twice. Okay, so just make a note of that, either mentally or on your sheets, that when we play the interlude, you're going to do the first line of the chorus twice. Okay, it's not that, it's that. First line of the chorus twice. Okay, so that's going to kind of, that's what I do. I tend to as well, I tend to not do the sevenths in it. I tend to just play as A, A, D, and then this bit, but you're with the sevenths is fine, all right? Now, if you want, you don't have to play that anyway, because if you want, you can have a little go at a solo using this chart down here. Remember that when we do charts, it's a bit like tablature in that they're kind of upside down, all right? So what looks like the top line on your sheet, this one nearest the top with the most dots on, that's your A string. That's the one nearest the floor, okay? And what looks like the bottom string, the one with no dots on at all, that's your G string. So you're reading it a bit upside down. So to play this scale, which is actually an A blues scale, when we're playing blues songs, and this song is basically 8-bar blues in the key of A. Hi, Esther. When we're doing that, we tend to use blues scales. If you're into your theory, that's a minor pentatonic with a flat 5. If that goes, just don't worry about it and play the dots. You'll be fine. All right. Now, that goes from putting your first finger way up here, actually, on the 5th fret of the E string. Normally we do blue scales with a different shape, but A takes you way up here, so I like to do it this shape. So we're going to do 5 up to 8, Then I've got three notes in a row on the A string, 5, 6 and 7. Okay, I'll do that again. So on the E string, 5, 8. On the A string, 5, 6, 7. And you can take that up 2 higher if you want, or 3 higher, sorry. You can go up to the 10th fret and the 12th fret as well if you want to. So 5, 8, 5, 6, 7, and if you want, 10 and 12. Now, if you're really into playing the blues, there's also another place you can do that lower down. I'm going to start it from a C note rather than an A note, and you can play down here, 0, 2, 3, off 3, off 3. That's quite interesting because you can play all your open notes down here, and you can just play the 3rd fret on each one. That's really quite helpful if you just want to break out of this one. You can kind of take it down here and have a little noodle. And the thing to do is just kind of have a little experiment. You don't have to go crazy. Let's see if I can bring a backing track on. This will sound really tinny and a little bit rubbish, but hopefully it'll give you a bit of an idea. If I just put that there, you could do just something like this. It doesn't have to be loads. That's the length of that whole interlude, so you haven't got very long, so just have a little noodle there. Just enjoy yourself. You don't have to do it. You can just strum along with me and you'll be absolutely fine. Yeah, the blues is such a cool sounding scale. It's just like one of my favourite scales to noodle about with. It always sounds cool no matter what you do pretty much with it, which is fantastic. And we'll build on that next week with more blues, because we're going to do 2 songs that use this scale next week. So you'll get loads of a chance to practice it. All right. Should we give it a go? See how we get on with our first one. We can always come back to it if it's an absolute disaster. It could be a disaster because I could go wrong. Who knows? We'll find out. I'm going to play that intro twice. And then I'm going to go into the verses and just follow them along as you go. This one's in way too high a key for me to sing in, but it's a really comfortable key to play in. So I've kept it in that key. So apologies if I'm very screechy. I'm not Paul McCartney, but I'll do my best. Okay, here we go. So if you can follow it through, just that intro twice to get us going. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Get back.
it's the last chorus, everybody. Get back, get back, get back to where you once belonged. Get back, get back, get back to where you once belonged. One more. I've gone bright red. That is so hard to sing. I apologise if anyone's pets or partners are screaming at them or barking or meowing or whatever they're doing. Not the partners, that would be a bit weird. hope you enjoyed that. Oh, what a great song, eh? I love kind of, one of the things that I loved about Let It Be was that the Beatles really went back to their roots. And originally, there's a few songs like Across the Universe, which are a little bit more sophisticated that they couldn't resist putting on. I guess that one being a George song, so they kind of had to put George song on, didn't they, towards the end. But originally, Paul McCartney wanted to go back to those kind of early rock and roll feel songs, you know, all the stuff that they used to play in Hamburg over in Germany when they first started out. At the Kaiser Club and places like that. And this has got that feel, hasn't it? We call it 8-bar blues because it's really a blues song. It features the notes that Paul McCartney sings are based on this A blues scale. So that's one of the reasons we call it a blues song. Also, we've got those dominant seventh chords which come up in the blues, and we've got the one and the four chords which are really common as well. And 8-bar blues is where we play 8 measures. And that's what we've got, because if you think about it, the verse and the chorus are both 8 measures again and again, pretty similar really. 12-bar blues, similar format, only extended, and we've got the 12 measures. So it's a kind of as simple as that. So, yeah, fantastic. Oh, that's a cool idea. Yeah, I like it, Esther. So, and I forgot to say, I always forget to say this. I'm so enjoying Kanikapila that I just, like, I rifle along with the songs sometimes and just, I can't help myself and I forget to show you things and get you to ask questions. So if you've got any questions whatsoever as we're going along, just let me know. And let me know how you're getting on with the songs, if you're enjoying them, if there's anything you found tough, you know, anything really. Ah, come on, yeah, nice to meet you. Nice to meet you. Is it Bine or Bina? I'm not sure how to pronounce that. Bina. Let's know. Cool. So, yeah, what Esther was suggesting was, is there a way to show you how to kind of transpose using Nashville numbers? And this is the cool thing. Those Nashville numbers are really powerful because you can use them in any key, right? If you think about it, we had A, B, C sharp, D, E, F, G sharp. Every key has a certain amount of sharps and flats. And let's go for a key which is really easy, like C, which doesn't have any sharps or flats. So that's just C, D, E, F, G, A, B, right? So what we would do is we would just transfer the same principle to the key of C. So the one chord would be a C, right? So this would be, actually make it easier for me to sing. Jojo was a man who thought he was a loner. A lot easier, right? If the one chord in the key of A was A, in the key of C, it's going to be C. So the next measure is going to be C7, like where we played A7, right? The four chord, we just count up, C, D, E, F. And then we're back to the one chord, C. So how powerful is that? You've got Jojo was a man who thought he was a loner, but he knew he couldn't last. Jojo left his home in Tucson, Arizona, for some California grass. So that means the chorus is going to go C to C7, right? Get back, get back, four chords, C, D, E, F, get back to where you once belonged. Then this bit's a little bit tougher, isn't it? We've got a quick flat 7, C, D, E, F, G, A, B. 7th is B, so we do a B flat because it says flat 7, B flat. And then we go to the 4 chord again, which we knew was F. So that quick bit's going to be B flat, F, and then C. I'll show you what I mean, the chorus. Get back, to where you once belong. B flat, F, get back, I forgot to do that bit, but you get the idea. And that works in any key. I won't do loads of keys, but I just really want to hammer home how this works because it's really amazing principle if you could get it. Say we wanted to do it in the key of G, right? Another common key, G. Well, G would be the one chord. G has one sharp in it, and it's the F. G, A, B, C, D, E, F sharp. If you don't know keys have sharps and flats in, you can use a circle of fifths to help you. That'll often have it written in. Or just Google them, and it's really good to learn a few of the common ones. C has no sharps and flats. G has one sharp, it's the F sharp. F has one flat, it's the B flat. All right, so that's what you can do. Barbara, I've seen your question. I'll come back to that in a sec. That's a great question. So if we did this in G, we would play G as the one chord. Jojo was
a man.
G7. 40 was a loner. 4 chord. G, A, B, C.
But he was another man.
Back to G.
Jojo left his home in Tucson, Arizona.
G, A, B, C.
But he gets it while he can.
How cool, right?
Get back. Get back. Get back to where you once belonged.
And you can work it out from there. It's so powerful because it means you can play in any key. And that's one of the things I want you to learn. So well done, Esther. That was a brilliant question. And it got me thinking. Absolutely. Way easier to sing in the key of C, that's for sure. I quite like G as well. It's just that little bit more relaxed than A. So, yeah. Barbara, the scale that we used in that interlude, that's the A blues scale. The A blues scale. And if you're into your theory, the A blues scale is an A minor pentatonic. That means a natural minor scale with two of the notes that clash with chords taken out to make it easier. 5-note scale, minor pentatonic, with the flatted fifth added. And the flatted fifth is the dot that's in the middle of the other two on that A string. So really, if you're into your theory, we've got 1, flat 3, and then we have 4, flat 5, 5. That's what makes it really bluesy. And we don't really, there is a major minor blues scale, but generally when anyone says play a blues scale, like play the C blues scale, they mean that minor pentatonic with a flat fifth, what we've got here basically. All right, so yeah, cool. Nice. Yeah, you got it. Indrani, you took the words right out of my mouth. We'll save Elton John for another time. Okay, let's have a look at our next song. This one's a lot more relaxed. Let's have a look. Oh, if I've got my sheets in the wrong order, because I think I've got the Belle and Sebastian tune next. But let's do Going Back, because that'd be really nice, actually. Yeah, we'll do that. So this is a beautiful song, Going Back, by Carole King, who wrote loads of songs with Jerry Goffin, you know, over in the kind of the Brill Building, New York, wasn't it, I think. So kind of lots and lots of classic tunes. Just moving my sheets about a second. Let's just move those out of the way. And she wrote this in 1966, And originally she wanted it to be sung by another singer, so she gave it to Dusty Springfield. And Dusty Springfield had a number one in the UK with it in 1966. This is all in the fascinating facts that Karen's put in the back as well, if you're interested. Lots of information back there. But later on, when Carol kind of made a name for herself as a performer as well as a songwriter, she actually covered it herself on her writer album. And her version is the one that I've taken the lyrics for this one. It's really sweet. Or we might have used Dusty's, actually. I think we went for Dusty's in the end, didn't we, Karen? I can't remember now. There's lots of different versions of this song. Another lovely version, which I really love, is by The Byrds. They did a version on their notorious Byrd Brothers, and they did a beautiful version on that, lots of jangly guitars and stuff. And that was lovely. David Crosby was really annoyed. It's part of the reason he left The Byrds, because he had a song about menage a trois called Triad that he wanted on the album. And the other guy said that was a bit too risque for the band, so they recorded a cover of this instead, which is a lot more tame. But it's a really, really beautiful song, this one. Now, this one has really common chords. In fact, you'll see that the chorus is very similar to the next song that we're going to do by Belle and Sebastian. But the verse only has two chords in it, two of the most powerful chords in the world. We've got the one chord, which is a C, because we're just going to do this one in the key of C, which is just a perfect one for most people to sing in, and a lovely, lovely one to play in. So C is your one chord, just sets you off on a journey. I think I'm going back. Now, you'd expect either the four chord or the five chord at most points in this song. And you could play, Carole King could have chosen the five chord, just plain Jane G here. C, D, E, F, G. That sound like this. I think I'm going back to the things I learned so well in my youth. Kind of works, but it's not quite mellow enough. So she did something really interesting and turned the chord that you would expect, that G chord, into a minor chord. And we do a G minor 7. It's like a G7, only that instead of having this finger here, we flatted it, all right? So we've got that minor third in it. This would be a major third. This one has a minor third in it. Really, really beautiful, beautiful chord. And that's it. The verse just plays off between those two chords. In terms of the rhythm for this one, we're going to just strum a calypso strum, otherwise known as the island strum by a lot of people. And that's your down, down, up, up, down, up, down, down, up, up, down, up, down, down, up, up, down, up. Remember, if you struggle with your ups because you've got two ups in a row, sometimes if in this pattern you do a little windmill, down, down, up, little windmill, up, down, up, down, down, up, up, down, up. Clever, right? Helps you to play in time. Okay, if you find that difficult, you can just strum downs or down and up. Okay, whatever works. If you prefer to think about this strum pattern as rhythm, I like to think about it as walk, running, and running. Walk, running, and running. Walk, running. And as long as you're doing that rhythm, doesn't matter if you strum up or down, you could even do this. Walk, running, and running, walk, running. Literally, as long as you keep that rhythm going, you get that pattern. Okay. Now for this one, because you want that kind of rhythm, Indrani's got a great question. What would be a good picking pattern for this one? I quite like I like to refer to as a there and back again pattern. So this would be really nice, Indrani. If you pick from the G string down to the A string, 4-3-2-1 if you're into your string numbers. Repeat that A string and come back again. It'll sound like and look something like this. If I bring my hands close, that would do it. C E A A E C 4 3 2 1 1 2 3. That'd be really lovely because we'd have this. I think I'm going back to the things I learned so well in my youth. That'd be really nice. Probably needs to pick up the tempo a bit. About there. To the things I learned so well in my youth. Oh yeah, that'd be lovely. I'm going to strum because lots of people will be following me on the online. And when I pick, people get a bit out of time, they've told me. So I'll just strum to make it simple. But that would be lovely. Let's try a verse then. So we're going to do one of those down, down, up, up, down, ups. Each one of those is a measure or one of these boxes. Let's give it a go. 1, 2, 3, 4. Think I'm going back to the things I learned so well in my think I'm returning to those days when I was younger to know the truth. Okay, now in the original here, as we've got written down here, and this was my original intention, I've gone for an A minor 7, which is no fingers at all. I found it doesn't sound strong enough. I found the more I've played this today, I feel actually I'm going to make an executive decision. We're going to change those A minors, sevens, to just A minor. Sometimes on the ukulele when you do something that's come from piano or guitar, because we can only approximate long chords. And some chords have like more than four notes in them, and it's kind of awkward to do on the ukulele, so we have to kind of approximate it. Sometimes some of the chords don't translate that beautifully onto the ukulele, and it was only really when I've played this today I realized that I think it wants to be an A minor there rather than an A minor 7. So at the start of the chorus we'll just hit a normal A minor, just like that. Okay. That's a relative minor of C. The relative minor in any key, you just count up to 6. C, D, E, F, G, A. So the relative minor of C major is A minor. Every major key has a minor key which has all the same notes and chords in it, just starting from a different number. The reason it's useful to know is that quite often the start of a chorus or a bridge will start with that relative minor because it adds a bit of melancholy. It's really beautiful. That's what we've got here. It ratchets up the melancholy. We've got A minor. And now there are no games. Then we are going to play this E minor as an E minor 7 because it sounds gorgeous. That's just like an E7 but without that finger on the top. To only pass the time. Now the 3 chord, C, D, E, the 3 chord in any key is the saddest sounding chord. And it should, if you're not a robot, it should tug at your heartstrings a little bit here. Now there are no games, melancholy, and then really sad. To only pass the time. Melancholy again, A minor. No more colouring books. Back to the 1 chord to relieve the tension. No more Christmas bells to chime. Then we've got one of the really most common chord combinations in all of pop music, but especially jazz. We talked about this last week, a 2-5-1. We're in the key of C, so D is going to be 2, C, D. G is going to be 5, 1, C, D, E, F, G. And C is going to be 1. And this is like the bedrock of all jam, all jazz jam. That'd be strawberries or damsons. So in jazz, loads of it is built of this. Fly Me to the Moon and Autumn Leaves are almost entirely a major 2-5-1 and a minor 2-5-1. It's super common. And Carole King loved her jazz chord, so that's what we have going on here. Now, the D minor, You just play a D minor like this, and to turn it into a seventh, you just add this little finger here, because this C note is the seventh note in the key of D. That's why I call it D minor seven. Now that chord, because of this note in it, wants to go to this note. This D minor seven always wants to go to this G seven, which then wants to go to this C. All right, so we have this. But thinking young and growing older is no sin. I like to add a little F note there. And I can play the game of life to win. That C, if you want to add the F note, is turning the C into a C sus4. I do that quite often. It's really pretty, isn't it? That's basically it, believe it or not, folks. There's not really a lot to this one. It's just really, really pretty. So we've got verse, chorus. Verse, chorus. That's like classic A, B, A, B format in jazz. Then we've got the bridge. And you'll notice the bridge is just the last two lines of the chorus again. And in the Dusty and the Birds version in this, they kind of just do lots of la-las. La 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 la. But in tune. Alright, so that's what we've got. Da la 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 la. And then we'll just go to another chorus. If you want to over that bit, you could use an A minor pentatonic scale to have a little go at a solo. That's all the dots on your A string. Just if you wanted to. You wouldn't have much time because it's a short bit. I did do a backing track. It sounds something like. You could just have a little go solo there. Just all the dots on your A string, okay, for your C major or A minor pentatonic. Let's give it a go. All right, let's try this one from top. Really nice and mellow. I think I'm going to play one verse through instrumentally just to get us going. I'll stay on close cam for this one so you can follow my fingers. All right. One, two, three, four. G minor seven. Hi, Karen. Back to C. Remember, this is just an intro. We're still going to do a verse after this. Here we go. I think I'm going back to the things I learned so well in my youth. I think I'm returning to those days when I was young enough to know the truth. Now I chorus. But now there are no games to only pass the time. No more colouring books, no Christmas bells to chime. But thinking young and growing with last chorus.
Now there's more to do than watch my sailboat glide, and every day can be a magic carpet ride, and I can play hide and seek with my fears and live my days instead counting my years.
One more chorus, because it's so nice.
Now there's lots more to do than watch my sailboat glide, and every day can be a magic carpet ride, and I can play hide and seek with my fists and live my days instead of counting my years.
Yeah, beautiful, isn't it? What a gorgeous song. From a gorgeous person inside and out. Wasn't Carole King amazing? I think it's absolutely cracking, that tune. There's a beautiful documentary on the iPlayer all about Carole King. It's almost like I read the universe on this one, because I had no idea that it was going to be on. But I'd chosen, I write down what songs we're going to do and work them out on the Monday. The week before the next Kanikapila, and then I send them to Karen and Esther to do the sheets, and Indrani for photos if needed. And so I'm kind of a week in advance. So I did this last Monday, this going back, and then on this Friday we were watching BBC4, which me and my wife often do, Sharon. We love BBC4 on a Friday night because it's always music documentaries. And lo and behold, they had Carole King night. I couldn't believe it. So there's a really wonderful documentary on Carole King, which is on the iPlayer. Well worth looking up. And then there was a beautiful concert where it's just her on a piano. She starts off on her own, and then she introduces some special guests. So she has like James Taylor playing guitar. And it's just really wonderful, kind of mellow concert, really, really fantastic. So if you can get access to iPlayer where you are, it's well worth looking that up. I'm pretty sure it will still be on there. The BBC are pretty good at archiving things if you missed it. So yeah, let me know how you got on with that one. Oh, nice one, Indrani. It's lovely, isn't it, to learn a new one? Absolutely. So, and I think Carole King's just, I mean, her and Goffin just wrote some amazing pieces. But her own stuff's lovely as well. Tapestry is just a wonderful, wonderful album. Well worth looking up if you enjoyed that. And look up the Dusty Springfield version. Dusty's voice is so kind of rich and smoky, isn't it? It's really beautiful. And then you get like the Birds version with all the lovely harmonies, which is well worth looking up as well. So there's all sorts for that as well. So thanks, Esther. Maybe I'll work out a performance of that at some point. It'd be quite nice to do a little chord melody section in the middle. It'd be quite sweet. So yeah, lovely jubbly. Talking of performances, if anyone is not signed up and they fancy it, don't forget that next month I'm at Bracklesham Ukulele Weekend on the Isle of Wight. So if anyone fancies a little mini holiday to the Isle of Wight, I'm super excited. The only disappointing thing about this one is that this is really nerdy. I'm so sorry. If we went a month later, the Glanville Fritillary butterflies would be coming out, one of the UK's rarest butterflies, and it's only found in the southern coast of the Isle of Wight. So, yeah, I'm a month too early, but it's going to be amazing. Some wonderful performers. I love these people I'm playing with. So I've got Matthew Quilliam, who's like proper underrated, does some amazing Formby style stuff, Hawaiian, classical, all sorts really. Alex Beds, who a lot of you will know from Southern Ukulele Store, but brilliant songwriter as well. As is Mark Gallagher, who's a wonderful songwriter and player. Played piano on my album Pocket Symphonies that came out a couple of months ago. And wonderful, wonderful player and human being. Ukulele Simon. He gets people dancing, believe it or not, at a ukulele gig. I saw a video of, I think it was Oh, gosh, I think it was Winchester Ukulele Festival, or it might have been one of the Dorset ones, Yeovil. Anyway, he had the whole crowd bouncing up and down. He did a version on ukulele of the song that won the Eurovision for Ukraine, you know, that really upbeat one, so really cool. And Kitluck's a beautiful, beautiful songwriter as well, absolutely wonderful player as well. Used to be known as Katie and her baritone, but performing as Kitluck. And she's going to be, or they're going to be, sorry, at the Ukulele Festival of Great Britain this year as well, which I'm super excited about. So this is going to be start of March, so in just over 3 weeks' time. Super, super excited about this, and all the details are on there. That's on my Facebook group. Don't forget the cruise as well. Who's coming to join me? Aruba, Bahama, come on, pretty mama. Sorry, I can't help doing the Beach Boys whenever I think about this cruise. I can't wait. I've taken a whole family to this as well, so you can meet Mini-Me, part one and part two, and my wife Sharon's coming along, so we're going to make a real family holiday, as well as obviously me teaching out. It's going to be a wonderful, wonderful, you're going to learn loads of ukulele, brilliant ukulele stuff, plus you get a chance to cruise around one of the most beautiful parts of the world. So what's not to like? Details again are on my Facebook page, or you can follow the details on here as well and contact Donna and Harry to book on, which is going to be fantastic. Oh, I'm a proper butterfly nerd, Indrani. I'm absolutely obsessed. I got so excited last week because I saw my first butterfly and I couldn't help phoning my wife to tell her, and she was like, oh no, that means butterfly season started. Which sounds great, but it means me dragging her into really steep fields all over the place. So, yeah. Lepidoptera, that's right. Yeah, that's it. Or the Aurelians, as they used to be known in Victorian time, after Marcus Aurelia. I don't know why that got adopted, but Aurelians are butterfly lovers as well. So, yeah, wonderful, wonderful. Yeah, cool. Oh, yes. By the way, don't forget to like the session if you can overall, because it really helps pick up the algorithm. Subscribe to my YouTube if you haven't already. And if anyone would like to send me a tip just to help with the running costs, because I do these Kanikapilas for free every week, you can send it to paypal.me/ukroom. Or don't forget, you can sign up to give regularly via my website, mattsteadukulele.com. And of course, you get 8 courses, my personal email address, video submissions, all the good stuff, free worksheets for my Wednesday lessons. So well worth subscribing if you haven't already to mattsteadukulele.com on there. I think that's everything. Oh, one last thing. Join me this Wednesday, 3:30, for the next live lesson, how to play and understand time signatures. So this goes through the basics of the difference between things like simple and compound time. Like, what's the difference between 3, 4 and 6, 8? Why aren't they the same thing? We're going to go into that in a lot of detail. And we're going to play some really, really cool Beatles numbers. So loads of cool stuff that you're going to learn in that one. So that's this coming Wednesday at 3:30 in the afternoon, UK time. You can find an archive of all the live lessons on my website at mattsteadukulele.com, and there's a blog on there which is well worth checking out, because the blog tells you when the next Kanikapila will be, when the next live lesson is, any kind of ukulele news, events and all sorts. So well worth doing. Brief. Okay, let's get on with the next song. Let's bring the sheets back up. This is a really beautiful one we're going to do next. I mean, I say that about everyone, don't I? But this is, it's quite an unusual song, this. It's from what probably, or possibly, my favourite album of all time, by a Scottish band called Belle and Sebastian. Now, these guys are still around now, and in fact, I'm super excited. I'm taking the weekend after the festival and the retreat this year, I'm jetting back straight off to Glasgow, because we're going to go and see Belle and Sebastian. They've got a little mini festival that they're playing up there, so I'm super excited. But yeah, they're still going, but wrote some beautiful, beautiful songs right through the 90s and the noughties and into the 2010s and 2020s now, so been going a while. This was from an album called If You're Feeling Sinister, which was released in 1996. I was going to wear my If You're Feeling Sinister t-shirt, but I completely forgot. So I was actually going to wear that tonight. Maybe I'll wear it next week in retrospect. One of my favourite albums, kind of really kind of beautiful lo-fi kind of acoustic stuff, but with violins and cellos and flutes. Wonderful, wonderful, wonderful. And this is a song, I chose this one because we're looking back, right? We've had Going Back, we've had, what was the other one? I've forgotten it already. We've had Get Back, and this is Don't Look, this is called Like Dylan in the Movies, but the chorus, the hook line, is Don't Look Back Like Dylan in the Movies. Because Dylan was in a movie called Don't Look Back, in case you didn't know. This one's in the key of C. The chords are really, really straightforward in this one. Really, really simple, but pretty. So the one chord is going to be C, and the verses just bounce between the one chord and the four chord. And this is a really common thing to happen in folk music, where we just go between the one chord for home and the four chord for a little bit of change. Okay. Now, I like to play a bit of a bouncy kind of strum pattern on this one. I like to do down, 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 up, down, up, down, 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 up, down. Now, you know, I'm not massively into strum patterns, so I think about this as walk, walk, running, running, walk, walk, running, running, walk, walk, running, running, walk, walk, running, running. OK, so that's a really simple one that you can play through. And we do that once per measure. So that would sound something like this in the verse. Notice how you just have one measure of each. Now in the first verse, this is the first verse only, notice there's a little note up here which says NC, and that means no chord. You get that in songbooks and sheet music and all sorts. It's a little bit misleading in some ways because it doesn't mean no chord, it means one chord. So when you play the F in that measure, just hit it once and then stop. I'll show you what I mean. If I play the first line of the first verse. See how I stop on the F? And then I'm back to... If you do that one, it's really important to keep counting. One, two, three, four. 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 That's it. So it's a very, this is way out of my comfort zone to sing. It's actually way below my range, but the chords sit beautifully in the key of F, key of C. That's why we're doing it. Lisa's kissing men like a long walk home when the music stops. Take a tip from me, don't go to the park when you're on your own. It's a long walk. Then we go to the chorus. And another reason I wanted to choose this one is notice similar thing to Going Back, we go to the relative minor. Remember, to find the relative minor, just count up six from the home key. C, D, E, F, G, A. So the relative minor of C major is A minor. But that chord is one of the most common to start a chorus. The next most common is the four chord. All right, so those come up really often. So just like with Going Back, that creates a sense of melancholy. Don't look back. And then just like Going Back, we've got the E minor. Only this time, instead of playing E minor 7, we're going to go traditional E minor. And again, that chord, the 3, C, D, E, that's thought of as a heartbreak chord. Whenever it comes up in a song, it's got a real kind of tugs at your heartstrings, right? Then to keep that kind of melancholy going, we've got the other minor chord in the key of C, which is D minor. To lighten it up a little bit, F major. Then we go again, A minor. Minor. This time, instead of a D minor, we've got a D major, and that lifts everything. And then the F again. So chorus will sound like this. Here we go. Don't look back if they follow you. Don't look like Dylan in the movies, on your own. if they follow you. It's not your money that they're after, boy, it's you. There we go. Nice. Yeah, this is our esoteric one for the night. This is me introducing you guys to something different. I'm a bit of a nerd, so I like to do that every now and then. So yeah. And if you get a chance to listen to, if you're feeling sinister, the album afterwards, send me an email or send me a link on Facebook to thank me afterwards, because you will love it. I promise you, you will absolutely love it. I used to listen to this on an old Sony Walkman. I had it on tape, and I used to walk through the woods and listen to these songs, and they just brought me so much peace and happiness. I just love it. In fact, this is like the soundtrack to my first year at university. Absolutely, just love this stuff. I forgot what I was going to tell you. Oh, yeah, so back in the day, they were kind of mystical, Belle and Sebastian. They purposefully didn't do any promo shots, so no one really even knew what they looked like until they turned up at their concerts. And they used to play really quietly at their concerts. People, whenever you went to early Belle and Sebastian concerts, people at the back would be going, "Turn it up!" But it worked. It was really quiet. It was really lovely. And so they had this real mystical thing. And their first album, Tiger Milk, they re-released it, but it was only available on 100 copies of vinyl. So it's really hard to get hold of. So the first time I heard it was that a girl from Canada, who I struck up a pen pal friendship with, sent me it on cassette, and I've still got that original cassette of Tiger Milk that I really treasure, with her little handwritten comments. It's really special. Anyway, so that's enough of about me. That's the verse and the chorus. Kara's got a question. So minor third is six, major third is still third. Do, 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 do. I'm just trying to think. I'm not sure, Carol, about that. Minor third, six. I'll have a think about that, see if I can work it out, Carol. Think if you can phrase it another way, because I wasn't totally sure what you're asking there. That's my bad as much as yours. I can't think exactly what you're asking there. But just put it another way, and I shall try my best to work that out for you. Okay, so yeah, that's pretty much it. The bridge basically is really, really simple. The bridge is like this extra section towards the end. And remember, as always, if you have both sheets available, if you can, it's a lot easier. I quite often print these out rather than have them online, just so I can have them next to each other. So you see, we have that verse, chorus, interlude, which is just C to F. Verse, chorus, interlude, and then we've got that bridge, which I'm just about to show you. And it's basically a mix of the chorus and the verse. So we've got C to F, like the verse, twice. Then we go to A minor, E minor, F, D minor, and F. I'll just sing it so you can get an idea. Two, three, four. Yeah, you're worth the trouble, you're worth the pain, you're worth the worry, I would do the same. If we all went back to another time, I will love you over, I will love you over, I will love you. All right, so just enjoy this one. It's ever so sweet, a gorgeous song. In terms of the solo, and we haven't really got much opportunity because the interlude is so short and sweet. If you wanted to, again, you could use the notes on the dots on the A string, which isn't A minor pentatonic scale, or the C major pentatonic. But if you're not sure, just the dots on your A string. Or just strum along and enjoy it, because there's not really much time for a solo. Let's give it a go, guys. Let's try from top. I'll come in on close camera. Apologies that you have to stare at my double chin, but it means you can see what's happening with these fingers and copy along. Here we go. Let's do the intro a couple of times. That's C to F to get us going. One, two, three, four. Let's do it. it twice more. Lisa's kissing men like a long walk when the music stops. Take a tip from me, don't go to the park when you're on your own. It's a long walk home. If they follow you, don't look back. Like Dylan in the movies, on your own. If they follow you, it's not your money that they're after, boy, it's you. Pure easy listening, settle down on the pillow soft. When they've all gone home, you can concentrate on the ones you love. You can concentrate, hey, now they've gone. But if they follow you, don't look back. Like Dylan in the movies, on your own. If they follow you, it's not your money that they're after, boy, it's you. Here's the bridge. Yeah, you're worth the trouble, you're worth the pain, you're worth the worry, I would do the same. If we all went back to another time, I will love you over. I will love you over. I will love you. If they follow you, don't look back. Like Dylan in the movies, on your own. If they follow you, tenderly you'll turn the light up in your room. Now the chorus. If they follow you, don't look back. Like Bobby Dylan in the movies, on your own. If they follow you, really quite they used to get a lot of kind of jip for being called twee, you know, that kind of fae thing, but I don't think they were really that twee. I think they just wrote really kind of really pretty songs, and they weren't ashamed of it, and I think it's really really beautiful. They often say that they took people out of their bedroom into the dance halls or into the nightclubs, because their later albums have some quite dancey stuff on it, like some quite strong beats and stuff, which is interesting. But the early stuff has this kind of really kind of melancholic vibe to it, which was really nice. It really touched me when I was like 17, 18, because, you know, I was a melancholy soul when I was younger. And, you know, I grew up listening to Britpop and like loud, like rock and roll and 60s stuff. And it was the first time I listened to something and it really kind of touched me. And I realised that everything doesn't have to be loud and like overpowering. It can just be really beautiful. And that's what I love about Belle and Sebastian. And like Esther says, yeah, they should be better known. They've got a kind of cult following. In the film High Fidelity with what's his bucket, forgotten his name now, really famous actor, anyway, High Fidelity, Nick Hornby's High Fidelity, really can't think of his name. Anyway, there's a famous scene where the guy, one of the guys in the music shop, is Jack Black. The guy who plays Jack Black is taking the mickey out of another guy in the music shop who's listening to the Belle and Sebastian track, Seymour Stein, and that kind of made them a bit more well known. But they're kind of, they've kind of got there on the indie circuit now, but still not as well known as they should be. The Field Mice, absolutely beautiful. They're on Sarah Records, a really lovely Bristol record label in the 80s and 90s. Okay, let's have a look. We've got one more track to do. I don't know why, if I got like super quick tonight, because we seem to be, I seem to have gone through a lot quite quickly. Let me know if you've got any comments or that on that or anything, and I'll do my best to answer them. Yeah, Drani, you read my mind. John Cusack, that's who I was thinking of. Yeah. That's it. It's quite cool because this track they're listening to is a track called Seymour Stein, which Stevie Jackson, who is a guitarist in the band, wrote about when the band met Seymour Stein, who is like the head of EMI Records. And Stevie couldn't make it, so he wrote this really melancholic song about Seymour Stein. And it's really cool because when I used to be in my old band, I got to meet Seymour Stein, and in fact, he asked me to audition in his hotel room, and my manager of my band told me not to, for various reasons, which I won't go into in a lot of details. But I always wonder, if I'd have gone to that hotel room, could I have signed to EMI? They had the Smiths, Madonna, you know, oh my goodness, but ho-hum. I'm happy being a ukulele teacher, and I mean that, so it's all good. I think Esther's answered Carol's question for me. That's brilliant. So yeah, that's it. Cool. Fantastic. Major third or minor third? The thirds we tend to think of in the kind of in terms of the chords. So like a minor chord, like an A minor, would have a minor third in it, whereas an A major would have a major third. But you got it. Relative minor, we call it. Yeah. So relative minor, that just means the key that has all the same notes as the major key of a different name. So C and A minor. And it's always the sixth note above. All right. And we can kind of think of the relative minor chord as well being that minor. Don't worry, Karen, join the club. Oh my goodness, the amount of times ask Karen and Indrani and Esther, the amount of times I send Facebook messages, then I have to explain what I actually meant afterwards, because you go back and autocorrect has put in loads of words and spellings and you're like, what even is that? So don't worry, happens to the best of us. Okay, let's have a look at a last song for today then. We're going to do an absolute classic. We're going to do Mull of Kintyre. And I really, really love this song. And I mean, I say that of every song, but I tend to choose songs that I like, because otherwise it'd be rubbish, wouldn't it? If I don't like songs, it's going to be hard to be kind of contagious about it and kind of enthusiastic. Oh, cool, you got it, Carol. So this one's another one that I love. It's called Mull of Kintyre. You will all know it, obviously, by Paul McCartney. And he wrote this about the land where him and Linda McCartney had the farm. And in fact, I think he still owns it. I think I've got that right. I love that kind of Linda McCartney, Paul McCartney romance. And it's such a lovely story, isn't it? And they were in the band Wings together and everything. It was so sad when Linda passed away. Kind of heartbreaking. Me and Sharon, we got married at Marylebone Town Hall because we wanted to get married in the same place that Paul and Linda did. So that's what we did. So we've got a real kind of soft spot for their beautiful relationship. And I love Wings as well. Just so great. All right. So this one's Mull of Kintyre. Now, this one is only three chords. So if you noticed, all of the ones tonight, I've tried to keep to a few chords to make it really good for you to kind of start to learn these by heart. And this one's really good because a bit like we did with that first song where we transposed it, we played it in two different keys. This song actually uses two different keys in certain verses and choruses. And you kind of need this sheet, if you can, next to it. I'll try and direct you as much as possible because they tell you when we're changing keys. You'll see we've got a chorus, verse, chorus in A. Then we've got a verse chorus in D, then we go to A again and then D. And it uses the most kind of common chords in all of music. That's the 1, 4, and 5. Remember, the 1 chord makes you feel at home or it feels resolved. We're going back to A again here. So that kind of sets the scene, right? We're in 3-4 now. So I'll give you a strum pattern in a minute, but you could just strum 3 times per these measures. Mull of Kintyre. Then we go to the 4 chord for change, and you can literally just count up A, B, C, D. Oh, mist rolling in from, resolve to the 1 chord. The sea, my desire, is the 4 chord for change. Always to be here, back to the 1 chord. Oh, Mull of Kintyre. So just like the Belle and Sebastian song, the whole of the verse is just the 1 and 4 chord. Again, super, super common thing to happen in folk music, which both of these songs were influenced by. Okay. Now, strum pattern, again, not massively into it, so I'll give you a rhythm first. Walk, running, walk. Walk, running, walk. Walk, running, walk. Walk, running, walk. Down, down, up, down, 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 up, down, 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 up, down. Really simple, right? What could be simpler? Oh, thanks, Anishka. Yeah, sign up. Come and have a go at the theory course. I think I've got 30 videos on there, starting right from the basics. It's well worth doing. It's a bit rustic, that course, because it's the first ever one I did. And I did it during lockdown to kind of bide my time and keep everyone entertained. So it's just me and a whiteboard in the spare room of our house. But it's got some great learning in, hopefully. I think you'll find. So, yeah, well worth doing. Thanks, Anishka. MattsteadUkulele.com, everyone. One of the courses there. Sign up to subscribe and you get all of those courses you can take in your time. It's literally years of learning. If you do every one at a time, you could be at it for years. So loads to learn there. And I'm always adding more as well. Anyway, back to this. Now, if you want to, see down here, there's a little note that says, why not try a touch strum? And this one, we can add what we call a touch strum to this to make it a bit more interesting. Now, a touch strum is where one of the down strums, instead of strumming all 4 strings, you just touch the top string, hence the name. And you could do it with your index finger with this. Do you know what, Esther, I've been growing my hair out, but I think I was a few years younger, so I got away with it more. I'm not sure it works anymore. But yeah, I love my hair in those videos, so I thought I'd grow it out. That's why it's going long. It's so funny you should say that. Sorry, it's just because Esther said this. Oh, thank you, Carol. Thanks, guys. You guys are like my, I don't know, I can't think of the word now. What you call it? I can't think of the word. Ambassadors. You're like my ukulele ambassadors, and I love you all for it. Thank you. So, touch strum. Sorry, right. I will concentrate now. Sorry. It's because we got to the end. A touch strum, you just touch that G string and then follow it with 2 down strums. Isn't that lovely? Mull of Kintyre. Rolling in from the sea, my desire is always to be here, oh Mull of Kintyre. It's really sweet, isn't it? So yeah, cheerleaders, groupies, thanks guys, thank you. So that's kind of what Paul McCartney does on his guitar. So I thought it'd be really nice to kind of copy that a little bit as we do it. So either down, down, up, down, or just down strums, or you can add a touch strum in, which is really nice. Now, sometimes, as I say, it changes key. So on occasions, this verse, we do it in the key of D, right? So the key of D, we do a similar thing. D will be the 1 chord. And then if we count up, D, E, F, G, G would be the 4 chord. So when we go to the bit where we do the verse in D, we go to D for the 1 chord. Sweep through the head. Let me just get my key. Sweep through the heather, like deer in the glen. Carry me back to the days when you went. See how we're just doing exactly the same thing, but we just use D and G chords. And that's really lovely because it's getting you to transpose in real time. Steady as I like it. Steady on, steady on. Oh, the amount of times at school, whenever we had the registers, ready, steady, go and all that. It's all good though. Okay, so that's basically it. Now the chorus, we've got one extra thing. We've got the five chord coming in the chorus. Now the five chord in the key of A, if we go back to the original chord, is an E. A, B, C, D, E, and we're going to play it as an E7. We often play the five chord as a seventh. All right. So in the key of A, the verses, sorry, not the chorus, I've got mixed up, the verses will sound like this. Just follow it through with me and have a go at one. We'll go A. Far have I travelled, much I have seen, then D. Dark distant mountains, a valleys of green, past painted deserts, sunsets on fire, as he carries me home, E7, to the Mull of Kintyre. Notice how we just get that tension from the five chord at the end. Mull, which resolves through the one of Kintyre. And then we do exactly the same thing in the key of D. If you want to do a verse in the key of D. Sweep through the heather, like deer in the glen. Carry me back to the days I knew then. Nights when we sang like a heavenly choir of the night and the time. Five chord in D, E, F, G, A of the Mull of Kintyre. All right, so you get the idea. You can switch between the keys. If you get confused, just do the highest letters when we're in the key of A and the lowest letters when we're in the key of D. And you can just follow it through. All right. Now there's a solo there where you can use the key of D major, but it's a very short one. So I haven't recorded a backing track, but if you want to have a go, the D major pentatonic that we use is second fret of the C string, that's D, up to the fourth fret, the second of the E string, to the fifth fret, second, fifth fret. So from the C string, it's 2-4, 2-5, 2-5. It's not in the key of G and Drani, but... Whoops! Oh my goodness! I'm so used to playing that in G, I can't do it in D now apparently. But yeah, that's it. Yeah, you will get a different sound on low G, Anushka. Yeah, I kind of like it on both high G and low G. It's nice. We can do that on a ship, Harry. Steady as he goes. All aboard. Okay, so I'm being daft now. Obviously, the adrenaline's gone to my head. So that's, if you want to, you can do a little solo when we do these little interludes, okay? Now notice, can you see on this page, we've got this little thing, we've got some little extra interludes down here, the outro and this interlude down here. Don't worry about the sus, we're just going to do D three times and A three times, a measure of each. D, A, D, A. That's all we're going to do for those, and it kind of just helps us transfer between keys. It's as simple as that. All right, I think we'll be all right to give this a go. Let's give it a try. It's going to test our following skills, this one, working out what key we're in and where we are. Best bet, just watch my fingers if you're not sure. And it's really simple, the chords on this, so I reckon you'll be fine following along. Let's give it a go. I want to say a massive thank you to everyone that's joined in tonight. As always, you guys are an absolute joy. I really thank you for your friendship, your camaraderie, and for all your support as well. So thanks, guys. It means a lot to me. So hopefully I'll see some of you on this Wednesday for the next live lesson. If not, we'll be back next Monday for yet another Kanikapila. But anyway, one more song to go. Let's enjoy it. Here we go. I'll be hanging around at the end to answer any questions. Let's do the intro, just A for four measures. One, two, three. Here we go. Mull of Kintyre, oh, miss rolling in from the sea. Desire is always to be here, oh Mull of Kintyre. Here's our first verse. Far I have travelled, much I have seen, dark distant mountains with valleys of green, past painted deserts. The sun sets on fire as he carries me home to the Mull of Kintyre. Have a chorus. Mull of Kintyre, oh miss rolling in from the sea, my desire is always to be here, oh Mull of Kintyre. Now a verse. Chorus in D. You can do a little solo if you want, but just strum with me. Okay, next up we have a verse in D. Sweep through the heather like deer in the glen, carry says, I can hear those bagpipes. Yeah, absolutely. I love bagpipes in songs. Going back to Belle and Sebastian, their third album was an album called It Could Have Been a Brilliant Career. Occasionally, you might get an email off me with that as my name tag, because I had that as my email for years, and I still use it occasionally. Could Have Been a Brilliant Career. That was the first song, actually. Sorry, the album's called The Boy with the Arab Strap. I'm being daft. But one of the songs on it, which was called Sleep the Clock Around, absolutely brilliant song. It's kind of quite twee, but it builds up and it gets kind of louder and louder. And at the end, these bagpipes come in. And the first time, I really wasn't expecting it. It really kind of blew me off my chair. It's just brilliant. But yeah, who'd have thought it? Bagpipes and pop music, but it works, doesn't it? So yeah, hope you managed to find that. I mean, that one's particularly tough, isn't it? Because you're changing keys. Going up, we're going down. We're in the key of A, we're in the key of D. But it's really cool, isn't it? Because it gets you thinking. If you can think of those in terms of 1, 4 and 5 rather than A, D and E, it makes it easier because you could play that in any key, couldn't you? Chorus in C would be C and F. Mull of Kintyre, 4 chord. Keep adding it to C. That's the way I think nowadays, folks. So when I go on stage, not that it happens very often anymore because I'm too lazy, but when I go on stage, if I'm playing with someone like Craig and Sarah and they'll suddenly say, you know, come and join us. We're going to play Autumn Leaves. It's in the key of C or in the key of A, whatever it is. I'm not thinking in terms of chords, I'm thinking numbers. So if I can't remember it, sometimes I go to Craig, you know, what are the chords in Autumn Leaves again? And he'll say, it's major 215 and a minor 215. And I'll be able to think in terms of numbers. And it's really, really useful. So hopefully you can start doing that too. Really useful to kind of analyse it. And we're going to do some more of this next week with the blues stuff. So we can look at two blues songs. They're quite pop-tastic blues songs. So don't worry if you don't like the blues. I think even if you don't like the blues, you'll like these. They're quite pop-tastic. But they'll kind of get you thinking about those 1-4-5 combinations, which would be great. Me too. I find it such a play. It's one of those ones that is such a joy to play, isn't it? Both on guitar and ukulele, actually. Works on ukulele as well. Works on guitar as well, which is really, really lovely. Obviously, Paul had it, the original in guitar, so yeah, fantastic. Ah, thanks, guys. Thanks, everyone, for another lovely, lovely and fun session. Thank you for joining me and having loads of fun and making it really special. And don't forget, if you are around this Wednesday, 3:30 this Wednesday, if you're a subscriber, you get the worksheets for this at no extra cost. Just go to the members area of my website and you can download these at no cost. All right. So subscribers, you don't have to pay anything for these. Otherwise, if you're not a subscriber, you can still get the sheets for my live lessons. They're £5 and they're available via my PayHip site. You'll see the link on the YouTube description or on the website, so you can find it there. And we're going to do time signatures. We're going to do some great songs. You've Got to Hide Your Love Away by the Beatles. Oh, such a good song. We're going to do Anna's Song by... my brain always goes at the end, doesn't it? What's his name? Oh my gosh, it's gone. Big Glasses. Anyway, we're going to do Anna's Song. Someone Rescue Me. Please, please, please. And I can't remember what the other one is, but some really, really brilliant ones as well. Oh yeah, we're going to do You Belong to Me, which is a really cool song in 12/8 time, an unusual one. So I think you'll enjoy that. So thanks, guys. Yeah, makes my Monday. Really appreciate it. Thanks, guys. There we go. John Denver! I knew someone would let me down. And Karen got it as well. Well done, Esther and Karen. Thank you. Thanks, guys. I just couldn't. I don't know why. It just wouldn't come to me. I was thinking Glenn Campbell for some reason. It's daft, isn't it? What the mind does sometimes, honestly. Oh, crazy. Right, I think if I haven't got any other questions, I'm going to love you and leave you. Oh, thanks, Karen. Karen got her copy of Pocket Symphonies the other day. I hope you're enjoying it. So thank you. It puts pets to sleep, if nothing else. So I hope you're enjoying it. There we go. I had a lovely, this is proper name dropping, but I sold a ukulele to the actor Tom Courtney last week. He was in, you know, Loneliness, a long distance runner, and Dr. Zhivago. And he's in the royal family playing ukulele. And he sent me some lovely emails, and I sent him my CD, and he sent me a lovely thing to say is enjoying it today. So it made my day, which is fantastic. Oh, thanks, Joyce. Thanks, Harry. Thanks, guys. Oh, brilliant, brilliant. Right, I shall love you and leave you. See you Wednesday, folks. If not, I'll be back next Wednesday at 6 o'clock. Sending all my love. Much love. Bye.